This conference will now be recorded.
Give me a minute. Sorry.
Yeah, so I thought I have no idea. Like I think it's related to data science, getting data, how to sort out the data and all. I'm thinking like that. So it's like a SQL tool. Yeah.
So it's a visualization tool.
It's a, sure.
So, it helps you to make decisions, to make a meaningful information out of the data.
Yes. Okay. Why Tableau in that case? Why not something else? We can do it through an Excel also, right? We can also make it visualization through Excel. We can make it.
It has much better option and it's much easier in making those charts and, you know, the visualization part.
Yes. So the control of this.
Yeah.
Okay. So first is, let's understand in terms of, let's suppose, Kirtana, okay. Let's take, we'll understand what is that we do using a Tableau, or why is that we are, why is that we would want to analyze? All right. Mm-hmm. Let's take case of a small retail store.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. What does they do in a retail store? Okay.
Your
transactions, right? You go onto retail store, you pick multiple items, put it into a basket, and do your transaction, and come out. That's it. Mm-hmm. Okay. Our work is simple. Mm-hmm. Right. Mm-hmm. Transactions mm-hmm. happen.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
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 Now, at the end of the day, or end of the month, or end of the year, okay, or end of the quarter, I would want to know, okay, what is the amount of sales I made in my retail store? Right.
Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah.
What is my sales? I would want to know what is my sales. Right.
Mm-hmm.
This is the top level. Okay. Let's suppose I said 1 lakh. 1 lakh is my sales. Okay,
mm-hmm.
then
mm-hmm.
what is my sales
mm-hmm.
for in a particular category? In a particular
mm-hmm.
category.
Okay. Category.
Maybe like cosmetics.
Uh-huh.
Okay. Or detergents.
Just a second, like I will log out from the other one.
Yeah, you can also go on mute, everyone. I just muting everyone so that it does not spoil the recording. Okay, and like this, okay, each category. Now when I say what is the sales today, okay, or a particular date on a day wise, okay, or week or a month or a quarter, right, or a year, right, or location wise. Okay, when I say location, it can be country, state, and all those things. If it's a big retail store like Walmart or like a Moore or, okay, or a big bazaar, there are big retail stores present countrywide. So every organization would want to know, not only retail store, every organization, whether it's a banking sector or retail store, everyone want to know what is happening within their organization. Right? What is happening within the organization? Okay, it can be sales or it can be any other activity. I would want to track it. Basically, we would want track all the quantitative information which were there was some small network. Okay, so I would want to track all the quantity information, whichever is quantifiable, basically whichever is quantifiable, like numbers, I would want to track that. Okay, qualitative information, employees talking or some such sort of things, not on the gossips, whatever is quantifiable, whatever is in the books. Okay, all the recorded transactions or okay numbers, we would want to track it. Want to analyze it. Okay, what purpose? What is the purpose of this? Why would I would want to analyze those all things? Once I analyze it, what is that I would want to do with that? I'd want to take a better decision, right? Better decision, right? Informed decision, right? Or a decision backed by data. Let's suppose you go to your manager and say that, sir, I feel that this retail store is not doing good, or this branch of retail store is not doing good. Okay, will they immediately shut down that business or shut down the store or do something? No, right? They'll ask you, okay, what basis you're saying this? Okay, how are you saying that this branch of our store is not doing good, or this product is not selling? Okay, then you go ahead and, sir, you can see the sales trend. Okay, for the last maybe 3 years, or last 2 quarters, the last 1 year. Okay, depends upon the business to business, how short the cycle is. Okay, or so which product is not selling, sir, or this product is hugely priced. When I did a competitor analysis, sir. I did a competitor analysis. I see our product is much in a lesser price. Okay, is it? It's lesser price when compared to other products. Okay, why should we pitch less? Our margins are reducing. We are giving a lot of discounts. Okay, or we should give a discount, or we should not give a discount. All of these things. Okay, everything, wherever I would want to take a decision. Okay, basically a better decision by the management. Okay, it's an informed decision, or a decision which is backed by data. Okay, I would go and use a visualization tool. Visualization tool to analyze my data. Okay, it can be Excel, it can be Tableau, it can be ClickSense, or it can be Power BI tools. Okay, these are only the not tools, but at this point of time, these are the top leaders. Okay, but these are not the only tools. There are hundreds and hundreds of tools in the market. Okay, you mentioned SAP PO is there, MicroStrategy is there. In fact, on top of this, these are some new tools, something called SciSense, ThoughtWorks. These are all your BA tools. So a lot of BA tools has come up in the market. There are thousands of products, hundreds of products, not in fact thousands, hundreds of products. Okay, everywhere, the work of every other tool is to analyze the data. Okay, but one tool is easier to analyze, one tool is this. Okay, everywhere there's case study is different. Okay, the requirement of a company is different everywhere. Okay, that's the reason all of the tools get to survive in the market. Okay, and let's understand, why do I need Excel rather than Tableau? As you understood, we don't want to do it in Excel, but we would want to do it in Tableau. Right? Okay, we know it's easy to do in Tableau, it's a bit tougher in Excel or something, but not discuss the generic points. Basically, what will happen is when Excel is a repetitive activity, cannot automate it. Let's suppose you build one dashboard. Okay, in future, if a new data comes up, it will rework it. To rework on it. Okay, no security. Let's suppose you send someone a dashboard or you send an Excel file. So I mailed it an Excel file. Can I control you that you don't forward to others? I cannot control through Excel, right? It's your wish. You can forward to anyone your wish. It may go outside of the organization. So there is no security. Then limitation in number of rows. Okay, limitation in number of rows. So Excel has a limitation, right? The number of rows. So all of these things, Tableau can manage. Okay. Your activity is not repetitive. Hi, Karan. I was just taking to the overview of what is that way, why it is that we would want to use a Tableau, okay, rather than anything else. I didn't miss anything. And Excel and Tableau has complete control on the security. Who would have an access? Okay, who would have an access of what data? Let's suppose you are Ashwin, Karan, Kirtna is there. Okay, let's suppose people, you three are from three different countries. And I don't want to show everyone's, let's suppose Kirtna is from US. I don't want her to show to Ashwin. Her data I don't want, or the information of US. I don't want to show to Ashwin or Karan's data, I don't want to show to Kirtna. Okay, it can be row level filters, okay, a row level security, okay, or user level security. So dashboard level security, so many things can be applied on a Tableau, which is a limitation in Excel. There's a reason people prefer a visualization tools and these are automated. Okay, automated tools means you do a development only one time, okay, and it can be used at multiple times. Okay, repetitive. So you don't need to rework it unless until some logic changes. You don't need to rework on anything. Okay, data refreshes is scheduled. Schedule through our tools. Okay, we have database something. Okay, where we can schedule the data refresh. Okay, so it is just simply like an Internet Explorer. People just log into we provide a link. Okay, just click on the link. How do you log into Facebook? They simply like a login and see what is happening within my organization, all the information within my organization. Okay, this is all about BA. Okay, this is all about business intelligence. Okay. It's just about building the knowledge. Let's suppose you buy a book and keep it in Almera. You don't gain some knowledge, right? When do you gain knowledge? When you try reading that. In the same case, you gathered the data and stored in your databases. Let's suppose there's lots and lots of data in my database. This is my SQL Server database. Okay, I have a lot of data in my tables, in form of tables. All right, but would I know what is happening within my organization if the data is just in there in the tables? No, right. Just query a table. I don't know. I would not know. Okay. Inner object and give your customers. Okay, how many customers are there? How many customers? Okay, I would only know is once I query it first, then I try to analyze. Okay, now can I know? Okay, which customer has bought more? Okay, who is my top customer? Just by seeing this table, I cannot know who is my top customer, right? For that, I also have to bring the orders information, okay, or the detailed information of that for that customer. Okay, so this is a separate table. So now when I run this, I only get to know orders. Okay, now I don't know which customer is an order, okay, because I don't have this is a fact table or a transactional table where I just told, okay, or for particular order ID, how much quantity a customer has bought, okay, and what is the unit price I have provided, given to him, and what is the discount, okay. And out of this, I don't know which customer is my top customer. I do analyze this. So for that is where we'll use a Tableau or any other BI tool, okay. Because we are in Tableau class, we'll discuss more about Tableau. Now let's go ahead and discuss more about Tableau. What are the types of products of Tableau? Is it clear? Why are we using Tableau now? Kirtana, Karan, any doubts, anything you would want to ask before starting me on Tableau?
Yes, I understood it.
Okay. Karan, you want to start something, you want to ask something? Karan, your voice is very low. I think your mic is too far.
Are you sharing the screen?
No, still it is too far. We're not able to hear you. Okay, is my voice? Yeah, I think my volume is less. Yeah.
Is it fine now?
Yes. Oh, so long I was not sharing it.
Okay, fine.
I was not sharing it. Someone would have reminded me. I was trying to write all of this stuff.
Yeah, I also thought so, but I thought it's only talking part. So.
Oh my god. Okay, that's fine. Nothing is amazing. Just I was writing an intro or anything. Okay, so I was just showing on the tables. So we have data like customer information, we have data like orders information, okay, in separate tables. Now I would want to know, okay, out of these customers, who are my top customers, okay, from this customer table. Out of this list of customers, there are 92 customers. Okay, I would want to know who is my top customer or who is making more sales from which country or which city. Right, only when we analyze this data, I'll get to know, right? So that is what is the use of a Tableau, where we bring Tableau into picture, we'll load the data into Tableau and we'll try to analyze it. Okay. So now coming back to the Tableau. Tableau basically has, in fact, four products. Okay, Tableau Desktop, Tableau Server, Tableau Public, and Tableau Online. What is the difference of these products are? Tableau Desktop is where we start developing. For a developer, is a Tableau Desktop. Okay, you can explore, visualize, analyze data, answer any questions, create dashboards, and everything is done at a Tableau desktop level. Okay. And now if you would want to share it to an end user, okay, you share it to a Tableau server, okay, which is a licensed product. We may not be dealing about Tableau server much because this is just 5% of your content, because once you everything 99.99% you do work completely here. This is an admin activity. Tableau server is completely an administrative activity to publish and control the users. Okay. Then whatever you develop on a desktop can also be published to Tableau Public, which is a free of use, free of cost. It is a cloud platform and it can be used freely. All your media houses, okay, all the newspapers, all the news channels, they all use Tableau Public to show the, you would see in the election results, right? A nice dashboards they try to represent. All of them are public only. Okay, so the Tableau Public is a free of where you can store your information, but it will be public to everyone. So we don't store any confidential information in Tableau Public, but any other dashboards, which is not non-confidential information, you can store it. Then comes something called Tableau Online, which is a cloud version of Tableau. Okay, rather than having a Tableau server, in-house server, which is your maintained in-house within your organization. And it is like a cloud platform. Okay, paper you use. Okay, that is a Tableau Online. So whatever desktop, whatever dashboards you publish or build on a Tableau desktop, you can also publish to Tableau Online. okay, which is a again a paid source. Okay, but we can look into Tableau Public. Okay, I can just create a free account for, I think there is also a trial period, but that's more enough for us to practice and learn. Okay, so where you can schedule and all, whatever you can do in Tableau Server, you can also do in Tableau Online also. That's the same features are available. So these are the three different products. Now, when coming back, let's go in much more detail into, so how do people work with Tableau? So as I said, we work on desktop. Once you build a dashboard, it can be used to web-based visual analysis. You can embed into a different product. Let's suppose I built a visualization, I would want to take it to my web page. Okay, or you would want to publish into a public website or a website within my organization. Okay, a visualization is just a small graph. I'd want to embed into a blog. Okay, I would want to place into my blog. Also possible in Tableau. Okay, all of those things can be done in Tableau. So, and it does not need any scripting for that. So, no scripting or coding. Fast, easy, and beautiful. Okay, someone from a non-technical background, it's very helpful for them to learn Tableau. That's a great tool, okay? Because there is no coding and no scripting, it does not lack in any functionality. Okay. And Tableau can connect to any sort of data under the sky. You can connect to different databases like your SQL Server. You can connect to big data. You can connect to spreadsheets. Normal, when I say spreadsheets, like Excel, CSV, text files. I can connect to cloud sources. You can load the data from anywhere onto your Tableau. You can connect and you can load the data anywhere onto the Tableau. Okay, so I'll come back on the architecture, because before that we'll go on to the licensing part, and then we'll come back to this technical part again. So basically Tableau is designed in three sort of licenses: Tableau Creator, Tableau Explorer, Tableau Viewer. Okay, Tableau Creator is the one is needed for a Tableau developer. Basically, for a developer, you would need a Tableau Creator license, which is $70 per month. Okay, and 70 into 12 months. Okay, which is billed annually. With this Tableau Creator, what all you get licenses? There are set of four licenses you will get with Tableau Creator: Tableau Desktop license you'll get, Tableau Server license, Tableau Online, and Tableau Prep. Okay, Tableau Prep is a data preparation tool. It's an ETL tool. We'll also be covering overview of, not overview, in fact, most of the concepts we'll be covering in Tableau Prep, almost all the concepts. Tableau Prep also, it's an ETL tool. Okay, where you do a data preparation on it. So this is for a Tableau Creator. Then you have Tableau Explorer. Tableau Explorer is for an end user, basically. He is not completely developer. He is an end user, okay, who would want to visualize what you have created, plus also modify something. Okay, Explorer trusted at an answer your own questions faster with full self-service analytics. Okay, it is more of a self-service analytics. So you can use whatever you are a developer, but you can also play around with it. That is Tableau Explorer. That is $35 per month again into 12 months. Okay. Then a Tableau Viewer is for a larger audience. Okay, where they don't have any role to modify it. So it's just, okay, information is given to them. Okay, they just want to see the information and analyze it. That's it. They don't want to create anything new, or they don't have permission to create anything new. Okay, or if you would want to spread the information across my organization. So for them, you need a Tableau Viewer license. Again, this is 12 into 12, $144 per year. Okay, so this is on premises. Okay, and then you have something called fully hosted by Tableau. This is a Tableau Online part. This is a Tableau Online. Okay, so Tableau Creator license is same here, Tableau Online. So Tableau Explorer, this is $42 and $15. Okay, why a bit costly it is here is because your server implementation, your server maintenance, okay, all of the activities are taken care of by Tableau. You don't need to worry on that. Okay, so what I'm saying, this all is about applicable to your organization, okay, not an individual. So for an individual, we just need a Tableau creator. Okay, so let's go ahead and start downloading Tableau. Then we add more features on technical part of Tableau. Because it just bounce if I go into all of this technicality. So how do you download? Have you started? Anyone attempted to download? Ashwin, Karan?
No, Ravi. Is it Tableau 10?
Tableau 19.2 or 19.3 version is right now.
Okay. So do we have to purchase it, or is it a trial version or something?
Yes, we have a trial version at this point of time, and I'll come back to that. I'm coming back to there. Okay. Tableau.
Yeah, sure.
.com. Okay, you can go to products, Tableau desktop, you can download Tableau prep, Tableau server, and all of these things. Try Tableau free. So this will take you to download up, start your free 14-day trial period. Okay. Once download this, okay, by just giving you some email, it could not be a business email, you can just give any email. Once this is done, so expiration is done, okay, 14 days is very short to practice anything. Then after that, we have Tableau also has some academic program. Okay, so there are some academic program. What they do here is they give you a 1-year license here. For that, what we need is we need some student ID card. Okay, it need not be yours, it can be anyone else. Okay, it can be your cousins, your daughters, anyone's. Okay, you can bring anyone's a degree license or degree ID card. If you say you don't have anyone in your family who is doing a degree at this point of time, you can simply go on to Google, okay, and you can just say maybe BTech ID cards. Okay, you can just search in Google. There are a lot of ID cards available here. You can pick it and upload here. So let me go into here. So there will be placed where you can enroll it. It is again come back to the academic session until we have this part. Get Tableau for free in the Tableau for Students place. I'll just give you this link directly, so you don't need to search it. Okay. You have to fill out these details here. Okay, your personal information. And once you verify it in the next page, it'll ask you to upload a ID card. Okay, or go there, pick some ID card which is. Okay, just pick anything, there's no issue. Okay, they're not verifying it anything. Okay, and they'll send, once you pick any license, just see that if it has, let's say, this ID card has 2019, 1890 card, something. Okay, just pick that and then your email ID. Just they would want that email ID card, okay? You can give your email ID, no issue on that. Okay, and give the school name or whatever is there in this ID cards and upload it. A license key will come down to your email. Okay, once you apply that license key, it will be a 1-year license be applied to that. Okay, I'm just giving this.
Hi, Ravi. In case I want to renew, extend it for 1 more year.
Not possible within the same system. We have to reboot the system.
Okay.
Okay, they catch what is that? I don't know exactly, but we cannot reinstall mm-hmm. on the same system okay. once again.
Okay.
Okay. After 1 year, if you would want to reboot a system, just do the reboot, and then we can go ahead and install sure. our email license once again. Okay. Yeah. And your ID card, new email ID, and all this. There's a lot of ways to do this. Okay. But you cannot do it on the same. You cannot renew it. Basically, it's just to encourage the student to learn. They are providing 1 year license. Okay, so I just given the link in the chat window. Immediately, without trial version, also you can directly go into this version. Okay, rather than you say that why should I go for 14-day trial period than for this? So you're just extending 14 days of your 1 year license. That's it. Okay, 1 year is more than enough for your practice. By the time we can enter into any organization, is it clear? If you yeah, have your yeah. systems, you can start downloading it. Maybe I can help you out. Okay, let me open. I have not upgraded it. I manage the 2018 point version, but not much has changed. So after 10 versions, they stop naming it as 10. Earlier it was 10.9, 9.5, 10.2 something. After 10.2, they stop naming it as 10.2 or something. So they're naming it with years. In fact, Tableau, ClickSense, I think everyone is coming with now the change the naming conventions of the licensing. Maybe basically maybe to recognize year wise. Okay, so the latest version is 2019. You can always see the latest version on the Tableau. And once you open, you see update to 2019.2.1. Okay, once you install, you can always keep on updating yourself. Okay, every now and then, every 2 months or 3 months, they release one version. You can just simply update this. You don't need to upgrade your license or anything, but you simply can update it. Okay. So once you install, you get a shortcut icon. Tableau 19.2. Okay, you would only see the latest version on your when you download. You only get downloaded the latest version. Yeah, you don't have older versions to be downloaded here. You only have the latest version to which is downloaded. Yeah, then we have a Tableau prep. We'll come back to Tableau prep later. Once you download, you get a shortcut icon on your desktop. When you double click it, this is the window you get to open. And these are the recently opened workbook or used workbooks. Okay, or created workbooks. And you have some sample workbooks at the bottom. You'll get some sample work which Tableau would have built this. On your discovery side, you have some few very short training videos which Tableau provides. When you click on this, it'll take to the web page. Okay. And any conferences, updated recent conferences, Tableau keeps on updating onto this here. Any conferences, it'll push it here. So you can get the update of the conferences. Okay. On the left hand side, what you see is all the data connection, different types of connections, what we can make and load the database. Okay, clear on the layout part. Now let's go on to load some data, then we'll see what does Tableau extract does and Tableau. So let's connect to some Excel file for today. Go to Microsoft Excel. Okay, and we can load some data. Let me load simple retail store data. I'll load just simple superstores. So this is provided once you download Tableau. This is superstore file. Tableau is also trying to build. And here is where you see the canvas. Okay, this is a data canvas. And so we loaded Excel file. Let me open that Excel file and let's try to analyze the data first. Okay, so here I have an orders information. Okay, what sort of orders I have made. Okay, all starting from a row ID. What order is it? Okay, whether high, priority, medium, customer ID, shipping cost, shipping mode, customer segment, which segment is a small business or home or corporate. Okay, what product category is it? What subcategories? Okay, product name. Okay, and I also have my sales value. Okay, sales, profit, and which postal code, all the information, very detailed information of each and every transaction. Okay, around those records, 1900 records are there here. And then I have some returns information. Okay, what is the returns? So let's suppose you order something in Amazon. Let's suppose you ordered 5 products. Right, for one particular order, it is not necessary that you always return everything, right? You may return something. Okay, maybe you didn't like the quality, or it didn't expected size, it didn't fit you. Okay, so these are the returns of a particular transaction. Then we also have something called users. Okay, like a manager and from which region he belongs to. We'll come back to this analysis of these two sheets later, but let's analyze orders information for today. So once we're connected to the Excel file, it will show you all the 3 sheets. Each sheet is one particular table for you. Okay. So what is a table? A table is nothing but a rows and combination of a columns and a rows. These are your columns and these are your rows. Right. A column is always vertical, a row is always horizontal. Okay, columns and rows. When I just drag and drop your orders information to your canvas area, and it shows you a data preview at the bottom. It is showing you a data preview at the bottom. Okay. So now we can analyze here how Tableau is trying to. So what does this data, how many records this data preview will give you? This data preview will give you only 1,000 records. This is just a preview, okay? But it's in the preview area, okay, or data grid area, it'll only show you only 1,000 records. Okay, for each column wise, it's trying to identify the data type of that column. Okay, how is it identifying Tableau? Based on this first 1,000 rows of your Excel sheet, each column wise, first 1,000 rows it will go and check. Okay, if the first 1,000 rows is my text, okay, it will decide as it is a text column. If it first 1,000 rows is a whole number, it will decide as a whole number. 1,000 rows are decimal values, it will decide as decimal values. If it is a date, it will decide as a date. Okay, thus you see, this is a row whole number. Okay, this is a text. ABC is a string column. Okay, hash, there are 2 types of hashes. There's a blue hash, there's a green hash. I'll come back to this. What is blue? This is a decimal value and this is a whole number. And these are all your text fields. ABC are all your text fields. There will be interesting data type, which is your globe symbol. This is a string field, but a geographical role has been assigned, which is a country has been assigned to this. That's the reason you see a globe. So Tableau automatically identifies based on the column name. If your column name is like location, it may not be identified. It may not give a geographical role to that. Okay, if it is something like a country, because country name is there, a geographical role. See, in the geographical role, a country is there. Any of these names are there for your columns. Basically, airport is there as one of the column. Okay, it'll immediately identify the airport names. It'll give the geographical, where is this airport is located, which part of the city or in which part of the country an airport is located. Or if a column name is like city, or if a column name is like a country or region, okay, if a column name is like a state or a province, a column name is like a zip code or a postcode, okay, it can identify this. It'll give automatically give a geographical roles and give a geo, these are globes. A geographical roles, say for a city, for a state or a province. And we have something called date columns. A calendar symbol is assigned. This is a date. Okay, that's what Tableau gives up. So Tableau automatically tries to give the data types. Sometimes you feel that the data type you provided is not correct. Okay, or I say I don't want my sales to be, I don't want to in a decimal, I would want it a whole number. Okay, then go ahead and change into a whole number. You see there is no decimals anymore now. You can change your data type. You just click and just change the data type. Okay, so let's suppose postal code, I don't want to be, it is always saying I don't want, by default it is setting as geographical roles. Okay, now I don't want the geographical role to be assigned to this, you can just say simply none. It immediately converted into ABC, text column. It is just simply a text column now. Okay. Go back, assign geographical roles, state or the province. Okay, this is your data grid area. And this you also have, this is where you see your data along with the columns. And you also have something called metadata, manage metadata. You only see the list of all the column names. From which table we have picked this columns, from orders table we have picked it, their column names and the data types. So metadata. Okay. You can sort this A to C, Z to A. Is a name for table. Okay, you can just sort the column names basically to identify your column names. And you say out of this, all of these column names, okay, I'm not going to use some of the column names. I'm not analyzing. Let's suppose I don't want row ID. There's no use of a row ID. Okay, I can simply hide this column and use this drop down to hide this column. Okay, you're hiding this column. Means when you're hiding a column, means you're not trying to load the data into Tableau. Okay. Here you need to remember that whenever you're extracting the data, you're loading to the Tableau memory, in memory. Tableau is an in memory tool. Okay, now let's try to understand the Tableau architecture. Where is the data lies? Where does the data sit in Tableau? Okay, so as I said, we can connect to any types of data sources. It can be your data warehouses, which is can be SQL connections, data marts, data mart and data warehouse is just the refined layer of data warehouse, data marts. Then your files, all your Excel files, CSV, text files, PDF files, all the files, and cubes, like SSRS cubes, these are, okay, design cubes. You can also connect to any sort of this data. Yes, there's multiple SQL connectors, MDS connectors, or any data engine you can use. Once you load, connect to this data, you load the data and the data is stored in a Tableau data engine technology. So what does it do? It tries to store in the in-memory and in a columnar storage. Okay. And it also tries to compress the data. These are the three main features which Tableau type does. So when we load, let's suppose you load 10 GB of data into Tableau, it's trying to compress the data and store the data all into the memory of your application or memory of your laptop. If it is a server, it will be a server memory. If it is a laptop, it will be a laptop memory. Okay, that's the reason these are all your memory consumption tools. Okay, laptop should do a best performance of a dashboard if you're doing huge data, at least 4 GB of RAM. For a practice, 2 GB or 4 GB is also enough. Okay. If it is more than that, you need an 8 GB of RAM. Okay. My laptop is an 8 GB RAM. Okay. So the more the memory, the more the number of data I can use, and the faster the Tableau dashboard performs. Directly proportional. Okay. And it does some compression. So a different technology, a lot of technology, it goes into it. And what is a columnar storage? What is a columnar storage? Okay. If you have come across columnar storage and a row-based storage, you will just try to understand this table. Okay. difference between this is an RDBMS. This is how a SQL server stores the data. So everything is treated as one single table. Okay, like customer name, product name, shipping date, profit. Okay, like also suppose this is simple a table, which is a row based table. But when it comes down to Tableau, each column is now split up into one single table, and each column would be given one ID, and would be split up into one single table. So this is a product name is one table, profit is one table, shipping date will be one table. Okay, customer name will be one table. These are columnar storage. This is how Tableau tries to store it. What is the advantage in storing in a row based and in a columnar storage? Anyone, Karan, anyone can tell me what would be the advantage of storing in a row based or storing in a column format? Any idea? Ashwin, Karan?
No idea.
No, Ravi.
No idea? Okay. So what happens here is in a columnar storage, the data extraction is much faster. Let's suppose now I would want to search for a particular product name, maybe Xerox. Okay, in a row base, what does it does is it will go each row, okay, complete row it can scan customer name, product, shipping date, profit. Okay, not there. Okay, here it is there. It'll come and search. It'll search row wise. It'll go like this 1, 2, 3. Okay, but in a columnar storage, it'll just go to directly to a product name. Okay, it'll go and pick this Xerox. So the data extraction is much faster. See, part taken through data to calculate and aggregate or a profit requires visiting each row, then fetching each row. Okay, so it will visit each row from that location, then it goes and picks. Okay, in this case, it has to go to each row. But in this case, part taken through data to calculate and aggregate profit is a straight line. Just it will go, just go to that particular line, whichever column we mentioned. It will only go and refer that column. Okay, and it will pick the value for us. That's the reason columnar storage is much faster in data extraction and data aggregation and data processing. Okay, in Tableau, we store the data in columnar database, store column values together, then a row values. These are somehow a Tableau is working basically. Okay, you don't do any of these activities, okay, whether to store data in a row format or a columnar format, but it's how a Tableau's technology data backend is working. Okay, then there's one more point I explained here. Compression. How does this compression works? So there's multiple varieties of compression. There's not one methodology you have to use for the compression of compression. It use something called run length coding. Okay, it also use something called dictionary compression. Okay, if you see, there are multiple accessories, right? Multiple Xeroxes, every Xerox. So what does it does? It's try to group them, okay, like 4 to 5 accessories, 1 to 2 every. Okay, so it does a dictionary compression first. So something which is starting from AA, okay, or AC or AV. Okay, dictionary compression would be applied to column values. Okay, so it'll only store one at that point, it'll only store only one time as accessories. It'll try to see complete value actually. There are 10 times accessories, a value called accessory. It'll only store only one time. Okay, it'll group it and it'll only store one time. Okay, so there's multiple techniques which Tableau tries to compress the data. Compression techniques are used to further optimize the TDA columnar storage. Each column becomes a memory mapped file. So like this indexing file, this is nothing called a memory map file. Each column, each value of the column would be given some ID. Okay, some background knowledge to go ahead and while provide the slides, we have to go through. If you observe on a direct connection on your canvas area, there are two types of There is some network issue again. Is it stopped? Okay. There's a live connection and an extract connection. What is it? Okay. Some light. Anyone can tell? Just by the name, what do you think a live and what is an extract? Never mind whether it's wrong or wrong, right? Right or wrong?
Live means you are working on that live data source, and extract means you extract from that data source and then work on them.
Yes.
Something like that.
Yes, absolutely. Okay. Let's say, tomorrow I'll prepare a smaller file. I think I don't have it at this point of time. Okay. Live means you're just connecting to live Excel file. Okay. I suppose if I add a row here, okay, and once I refresh this, immediately a row will come down to my Tableau. Okay. But in extract, it does not come that way. Once you go into sheet, I'll show you how does an extract get refreshed. Let's store these two files. Okay, this data, the same amount of data in a live connection and in an extract connection. Let's observe the file size. Okay, I'll just save this file and the live connection, go to file, save it. Okay. Before that, let me create a folder for you people. Whatever work we do on a day-to-day basis, we'll store it here. What should I give the name? Okay, I would want to store into this folder. Let me take this path. Okay, so in this, I'll store it as live. What is that I'm storing? I'm storing twb.twfile. Tableau workbook. TW is nothing but Tableau workbook. Workbook. There is a live connection I'll store. I have live TWB. And now I'll also make an extract connection and I'll do a save as. Extract will include all the data. Let me do a save as and we'll do a extract. Okay. When I try to do an extract, a new file also gets generated. What is that file? To save the workbook, you must either create the extract, or I would want to create an extract. Create extract. It'll try to create something called dot hyperfile. I'll explain what is a hyperfile. Okay. So all of the data is now brought into a hyper format. So hyper is a technology which Tableau has brought down. I think they acquired this hyper, a company called Hyper in the year 2017 around. Okay, and this will help you to integrate, okay, all your traditional data warehouses, okay, your ETL tools, your analytical data, your OBR relationship data, everything into a single platform. So this will help you to store more amount of data, compress in higher fashion, okay, and the data processing is much faster using the hyperfile. Okay, if you go back and check, so hyper is just a data file for us. If you see, it is showing you 320 KB. Means a complete data from your Excel is now stored into your hyper file. If you delete your Excel file also, still it does not worry about for the extract. But for a live, if you delete the Excel file from the source, it will throw us an error. Okay. For an extract, you can go and work offline. You don't need any network connection. You can just go and work offline. Okay. In fact, for an Excel file, you don't need a network connection. But if you connected to some databases, let's suppose you're traveling, you connected to some databases. Okay. So a network should always be there, right? But in that case, if you're connected to some database, you always do an extract and store the data in a form of hyper. And you don't need any more database connection to be available. You can work offline and extract. Okay, extract will completely store the data in your memory, okay, in your i.hyper file and in the memory file. It's a completely, and the performance of a dashboard will be much faster when you do an extract. Okay, I'm not going into more detail about what is the performance. The fastness, basically the fastness of your data or the fastness of your visualization. Okay, it'll be more fast when you use an extract file. Okay, and the live connection will be a bit slow because it always has to go and hit the database. Okay, any query, it'll go and hit the database. If a database is slow, your Tableau will be slow. Okay, so direct connection to fast databases, which is a live connection to fast databases, in-memory extract slow database, that is your extract connection for a slow database. If a database, you think like there's an RDBMS systems, these are your slow databases. Now you have columnar databases. So what are some columnar databases? You guys have any idea? If you have not heard of a columnar, this thing, you have not heard of a columnar databases also. Your Vertica, which is a columnar database. Your MongoDB, which is a columnar databases. Okay, and your all your Hadoop systems, your big data systems. Okay, these are actually a file base, like HBase. Okay, and there are many other this thing actually, all my databases. What are your row-based databases? It's an RDBMS. These are your SQL, your Oracle, okay, your MySQL, all of this stuff. Okay, your Teradata, all are your RDBMS systems. These are a bit slow. These are your slow databases. Because query is slow here. Basically, why we call it a slow database? Because the query is slow. Because, as I said, right, I explained to you, the query has to go line by line here. Okay. These are faster databases. Okay. All the new databases are coming up are all your faster databases. Okay. All databases. Your querying of data is much faster in this. Okay, clear on a connection of a live connection and extract connection. If you see, the live connection is just 25 kb because it didn't bring all the data for us. Okay. Without this, next, let's suppose if I delete this part. Okay, I cannot delete this without. Connection can't be completed because the file is open in Tableau Hyper Database Engine. Okay, Hyper is the database engine for you. Okay. Okay. Here, so I'm not going to creation of a dashboard or anything. I just want to be comfortable with the process. So we'll start tomorrow. Any doubts, anything you would want to, don't worry. I can answer, I'll answer. Ashwin?
So will we be working with solely with Excel or any other data connection also? We'll be dealing.
We'll be connecting to yes. We'll be dealing with SQL Server. SQL. We'll be using Vertica.
Mm-hmm.
after obvious data mining.
Okay.
Right into every connected to any other database is same. Okay. Mm-hmm. If you just have a credentials, so you can just bring and connect to any other database. But what we'll look into is a SQL server. Okay, we'll connect it to a SQL server and we'll also connect it to HP Vertica.
Okay.
This is a columnar database and this is a row-based database. Okay. If you have any other database, we can should be Google Analytics also. Google Analytics also you can connect. Hello.
Sorry,
there was a network issue. I had to change my network. Sorry, if you have asked anything else, any other question, I could not hear.
No, that was it.
Karan, you would want to ask anything?
Nothing from my side.
Okay. So this is a sequence. I think you guys have gone through the content.
Yeah.
So we'll follow the sequence of the content. Okay. So whatever we have completed the course, so we'll follow the same sequence. Once we complete this, we'll go to Tableau private. Or the other way is also okay for me, because there's nothing dependency on this. Okay. So we'll first finish off this thing, then we can go to Tableau prep. So we'll be taking the first few classes will be very slow, so that you guys are up to the mark. Then we'll can take up case studies and try to resolve that. Okay. So whichever classes we complete, we mark it as done, so that I don't miss out any single topic.
Sure.
Okay. And all the classes, I would be sharing the recording session. A link I'll be providing, a GoToMeeting link, which will be an AWS link. I would recommend you to download the video. It may be available for the future, may not be available for the future. I cannot guarantee that. Okay.
Uh-huh.
So as and when I send a link, download it and name it to the according to the topic wise, so then in future if you would want to refer back, you don't need to search it, you can name it date wise and topic wise. Follow that from the beginning of the day, if not you'll lose it out. Chalo then, have a great day. Thank you. Bye-bye.
Thank you.